just love that. It just touches my heart. Yeah, it's really
nice.
Strong work. Mark, can you talk a little bit about, I mean, we see this work and it's, you know, such sophisticated art making, and, you know, it's so hip and challenging and postmodern. It's multimedia, it's cross-cultural. What do you have to say about giving difficult art to young children?
I think they just take it and run. I think that being an artist who went through art school and kind of learning boundaries, a lot of the students, if you just don't have those boundaries, they just keep making it.
So
and I think that was really nice with the projects, especially what was coming out of the stove project, where it was really about people documenting themselves and kind of addressing what documentation has been for a lot of people, and it's been a kind of a top-down documentation,
right,
they really don't have anything to say, or any voice really is heard from them.
Well, that actually is a good segue to a description of this project. This work at Stowe is funded through an initiative called Building Community Through the Arts, which is a collaboration of many different community leadership organizations in Humboldt Park, including the Institute of Puerto Rican Arts and Culture. And it's supported by LISC Chicago and the Joyce Foundation. And we've been really grateful for the support they've had there. But as you pointed out, Mark, you build community through the arts by giving voice to the people of the community. Those images in that Stowe document were created by digital cameras that Co-op Image found inexpensively and gave to all the kids.
Yeah.
So,
and most importantly, it was just the energy and the engagement that the students had to just do it themselves, that this is documentation, this is our lives.
And I love that there's this combination of the kids' current lives and this realistic documentation of this Puerto Rican community, and then there's also this imaginative leap to looking at ancient Taino culture and ancient Aztec culture and all this imaginative creative animation that the kids are doing. Any last words that you want to put in about the role of artists in schools, about what schools have taught you, about what education needs to be for kids in the 21st century?
I think working in arts education has really made me think about the role of arts in education, that it has to be part of the educational system. We can't go on with these classrooms with no sense of linkages anymore. And this is what art does, or how I see art works, that it makes links with other things that inform a topic, that informs a history. So
anything that you've learned by working with wonderful teachers in the CAPE program. Chicago public school teachers get a bad rap. We've had wonderful, wonderful colleagues. Anything as we conclude that you want to say about those teachers in our schools?
Oh, I've met some brilliant teachers, and I've learned so much about teaching from them, and they are good teachers.
Well,
despite all our
let's conclude with that. Thank you, folks. We'll see you next week.